Okay, first question. Who is someone that doesn't decide if they go in or out? That's a prisoner. And today, you're gonna be a true detective solving some prisoner riddles. Ready? Here's a task for you. Take a good look at these three houses. In one of them, a person who recently escaped from prison resides. In which house do you think they live? If they just escaped from prison, they're very alert and surely ready to flee immediately and as fast as possible. Look at the way the cars are parked. Two are parked with the back facing the road and one is pointing towards the street. If a car is parked pointing towards the street, it's faster to drive out. So it must be the runaway prisoner's house. A prisoner has a chance to escape prison. He has a choice of two doors. Behind one, there's freedom, and the other one leads back to his cell. He doesn't know which is which. In front of either door, there's a guard. One of them always lies and the other always tells the truth. But again, he doesn't know which one is which. The prisoner can ask one question. What question should he ask to get out? He should ask either guard, is the lion guard in front of the freedom door? If he says yes, there are two options. Either he's telling the truth or he's the liar. And so he stands next to the cell door. In any case, the prisoner should pick the other door. If the guard says no, then it's either the truth and the door is then the freedom door. Or it's a lie, but it still remains that it's the freedom door. So, in a case of a no, the prisoner should pick that door. A prisoner is trying to escape. He managed to leave the cell and found an underground tunnel, but it only led him to three doors. All of them didn't look safe. Behind the first door, there were two guards who would see him and take him back to prison. Behind the second door, there was a room full of lasers. Behind the third door, there was a room with the floor full of broken glass. Which way is safer? The prisoner should pick the last door. The floor is covered in broken glass, but he's wearing shoes, so it can't cause him much harm. Another prisoner is trying to escape, and he almost succeeded. There are now three doors in front of him. Behind one, there will be three hungry and angry dogs. Behind the second door, there will be an explosion in 5 minutes. Behind the third door, there's a guard. Which door should the prisoner pick to get out successfully? He should wait for 5 minutes until the explosion and then use the second door to get out. Now here's a logic puzzle. An inmate had a visitor. A guard asked him who it was and he said,
"I don't have any siblings. This man's father is my father's son."
So who visited the inmate? Since the prisoner doesn't have any siblings, then my father's son is him himself. And he is the father of the guest, so the guest is his son. An inmate got sick, and now he has to take pills to keep his illness under control and also not to infect anyone else. He got three pills which he has to take every hour. How long will it take him to take all the pills? It'll only take him 2 hours. One he will take immediately, another one after 1 hour, and the last one after 2 hours. An inmate escaped from prison. His best friend was waiting for him in a car, so the prisoner hopped in and they drove away. The police are now chasing them. This is the car with the prisoner, and these two cars are identical. Watch the car with the prisoner carefully. Which car is the escapee in? It's the one on the left. Okay, now it's going to be even harder. Watch the car again. They'll go faster. Which one is it? If you said this one, then you're right. Okay, one last time. And will you catch the prisoner? Watch the cars carefully. Which one is it? It's this one, correct. Congratulations, you caught the prisoner. Another prisoner escaped, and police tracked him back to a recreational hotel complex in a forest in the suburbs. A detective entered a sauna he had seen the prisoner sneaking in a minute ago. There were four men sitting there. They said they were friends and had been sitting in the sauna for around 10 minutes and hadn't seen anyone else entering. Which one is the prisoner? It must be this guy. Look, everyone is wet and sweaty, and he's not sweating at all. He must have just entered. Another day, another prisoner managed to escape. This time, the police were sure that the prisoner was somewhere in the zoo located not far away from the prison. They entered and went up to one of the zoo's caretakers, asking if he had seen a prisoner there.
No, sir, I guarantee that no prisoners entered this area, said the caretaker.
It was suspicious. Why was he so sure about that? All right, thank you for your assistance. By the way, why is this cage empty?
Oh, I'm cleaning it. The zebras were relocated for a while.
The police arrested him as a prisoner. Why? The sign on the cage says that it's the cage with camels. If he was a real caretaker, he would know this. Now, I'll be showing you several houses, and your task is to determine in which house a criminal lives. For example, look at these two. Which room belongs to a criminal? This one. Look. There's a black mask on the chair. What about these two houses? Do you see something suspicious? There are orange overalls in the wardrobe. They must belong to a prisoner. Another one for you. Can you see any signs of a prisoner? Look, there's a huge bag with money hidden. This is the place. There are four prisoners who get a chance to get out sooner if they solve a riddle. There are four hats, two black ones and two white ones, and everyone is aware of that. They stand like this. The first prisoner is in the front and can't see anyone. The second prisoner can only see the first one. The third prisoner can see both. Behind a wall, there's the fourth prisoner, who can't see anyone. Each one of them got a hat. None of them knows the color of their hat. They can only see others as described. Any one of them can make a guess regarding the color of their own hat. One attempt for all of them. But if the person gets it right, all four of them will get out. How can they do it? The third prisoner can see two hats in front of him. If they're the same color, then he knows his own hat is the other color. But if there are two different hat colors in front of him, then he can't be sure. In this case, he'll stay silent. Then, the second prisoner understands that they have hats of different colors. He can see the hat color of the first prisoner. So he will call out that his own has the other color. Hey there! Today, we'll test your visual attention and intelligence. Let's see if you have a sharp eye, shall we? Let's start by training your eyes for today's challenge. Here's the first picture, and your task is to find the odd one out. Can you do it? Yes, it's right here. Okay, another set of emojis. This time, all of them come in pairs except for one that's a single Pringle. Can you find that one? Yes, here it is. I think you got it. Let's make the task a bit more complicated now. How many B's can you find among all these D's? I'll give you 30 seconds for this one. Time's up. There's three of them. I hope you haven't lost anything. A similar task, but now you should find B's among eights. How many do you see? You have another 30 seconds to do the job. This time, there's nine of them. Have you found them all? Look at this pile of eggs. Can you count how many eggs there are here? Well, there are five layers, and all of them are perfect squares. A 5x5 one at the bottom, then there's a 4x4 one, then a 3x3 one, a 2x2 square, and one last egg on top. So, we multiply, sum up the layers, and get... How long did it take you to figure it out? Now, it's time for a tricky riddle. Take a look at this picture and tell me how many circles there are here. A little hint for you. Three isn't the correct answer. Think outside the box. There are four circles, three big ones that you obviously see. But look, there's the fourth one, this little part of the question mark. Another circle riddle, but you can relax. This one's not so tricky. Just relax and count. How many circles are in the picture? Well, let's count, starting right with this small circle in the middle. One, then the white one behind it. Two, then the blue one behind the white one. Three, then four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. Nine circles. Did you get this one right? Susan is a genie hunter, meaning she's been out and about looking for a lamp to make her wishes. After decades of searching, she's finally found one in an old cave. But it turns out that the lamp is guarded by spirits. As soon as Susan touches the lamp, it gets two duplicates, and they start switching places. Look, this one is the original lamp. Watch it closely, and then tell me where it is. So, where is the correct lamp? Here it is! Even though Susan's guess is correct, the lamp starts switching places again. And even faster than the last time. Keep your eyes wide open to have Susan's back. Where is the lamp with a genie? This is the one. Did you get it right? That's very unfortunate, but now there's a fourth lamp. Can you still track the original one? Let's see. Ready, set, go. Now you can make your choice. Yes, exactly. This is the one. Another spin, faster and wilder than all the previous ones. Okay, now you choose. This was the last time, and Susan got it right. Now she's finally granted her three wishes. And what would you wish for? During summer break, Jane's friends invited her to go on a month-long cross-country hike. Jane wasn't a fan of hiking, especially a hike that long. But she also didn't want to come across as a couch potato, so she told her friends that she was going on vacation with her family. In July, Jane found a vacation photo of her parents and her sister taken in April and photoshopped herself into it. Then she sent it to her friends. When her friend saw the photo, they realized it was fake. Inspect the photo and tell me how they knew. Look at the other people in the photo and their clothes and hair. It's obviously windy. But Jane's hair and dress are perfectly still. Ellie had always wanted to get a cat, but her mom wouldn't allow her. Once, she found a kitten in the street, brought it home, and hid it from her mother. Ellie kept it for a week without her mom knowing about it. But one morning, Ellie went downstairs to have breakfast, and her mom realized that her daughter was keeping a cat upstairs. How did she understand it? Look, Ellie's clothes are covered in cat hair. Kenzie, Nell, and Hannah were spending the day on the beach. Their parents left to go get some food and told the girls not to go into the water until they came back. The girls were reading, building sandcastles, and getting tanned. When their parents returned, they understood that one of their daughters hadn't listened to them and had gone swimming unsupervised. Which one? It was Nell. Look, the towel she's lying on is wet. In a parallel universe, it's only allowed to have fun and eat candy. No one there ever reads or studies. Mrs. Relham came back home after a long and fun day at a club. Her three daughters were supposed to have a fun day. Mrs. Relham asked them what they'd been doing. Hannah said, "I was out with some friends." Elle said, "I went to have a manicure with a classmate." Ava said, "I stayed in the room playing computer games with my online friends." Still, Mrs. Relham could tell that one of her daughters lied. Who was it? It was Elle. She said she had gone to get her nails done, but why do they look so untidy then? Okay, a new task now. I'll be showing you some photos, but these photos aren't ordinary. In each one of them, there are three hidden words. Your task is to find them. Do you think you can do it? Well, let's see. Here's the first one. Try to find three words hidden in it. This one wasn't too hard, was it? Here are the words. Now let's make it just a tiny bit harder, but the rules are the same. There are just three words. I believe in you. Let's go. Here, here, and here. Have you found them all? Okay, the third one for you. So keep your eyes wide open. Okay, here they all are. I hope you've succeeded. If not, it's okay. To be honest, I couldn't find them myself. Well, now it's pretty much level impossible, but that's the moment we've been training for. Can you find all three words hidden in the photo? Here's one. Here's the second one. And here's the third one. It was tough. I'm proud of you. Ashley is going on a month-long vacation, but she has trouble packing. Or it's more that she has trouble finding things she needs in her house. Can you help her? I'll be showing you the pictures of her house and the items she needs. You just have to find them in the picture. Okay, let's start with her bedroom. Can you see these items there? She needs her laptop, her book, a charger, and her hair straightener. Okay, here they all are. Have you found them? The next room is a closet. She needs this particular dress, a hat, a swimsuit, and flip-flops. Can you help Ashley find them? Here's the dress, that must be the hat, the swimsuit, and here are the flip-flops. All here, next. Welcome to Ashley's living room. Here, she needs to find her documents, her wallet, a purse, and her heels. You know what to do. Here, 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 and here. Great job! And finally, the bathroom. Now she only needs her sunscreen, lipstick, a small mirror, and some hair ties. Here they all are. I hope you've managed to find them all. Thank you for your help today, and I hope you've had fun.
Look at this picture. Where is the bank robber hiding? He's over there, behind the bushes. The bank robber has managed to escape from the police. Try to figure out where he's hiding now. See that maintenance hole? That's where the criminal is. This robber is just too fast. He's escaped again and is now hiding in one of these fitting rooms. Help the police find him. He must be in the middle fitting room. See that bag with all the cash he's stolen? Look at this image attentively and try to figure out what's wrong here. In reality, the guy is holding a tube of toothpaste in his left hand, but in the reflection in the mirror, he's got nothing in his hand. How about this picture? What's wrong here? Is this lady charging her cat? This picture looks off too, but what exactly seems strange? It's the girl in the front. She isn't reflected in the water. Now the next image to challenge your observation skills. Does anything strike you as odd in this picture? Look at the TVs. They show different things in reality and in the reflection in the mirror. Can you figure out what this means? Right you are! F plus arm equals farm. Now this one is a tiny bit tougher. What does this rebus mean? Storm, TH. It's thunderstorm. And how about this one? Can you crack it easily? Re plus boot equals reboot. Ew, insects! But can you guess this word? How many ants are there? 10. So the correct answer is 10 plus ants equals 10 ants. I have 8 fingers and 2 thumbs, but I'm not alive. What am I? I'm a pair of gloves. Which person is different from the others? Right you are, this one with shorter hair. Try to figure out which emoji is the odd one. The one at the bottom, it looks pretty angry. I challenge you to find a cat that's different from the rest. Right! It's the one closer to the bottom, facing away from you. Which image is the odd one? This little rebel is turned in the opposite direction. Have you noticed anything wrong in this picture? The ball. They're playing soccer, not basketball. Which cow is different from the others? The one waving at you, of course. How about these burgers? Do any of them stand out? See, this burger is smaller than the rest. There's something wrong with this picture. What exactly? It's the river. It seems to just disappear under the bridge. Is there a hole in the ground there? Which emoji is the odd one? The one with its mouth missing. There's something that doesn't seem quite right in this picture. But what? The rainbow. Its colors are a bit messed up. Can you find a pig among these birdies? Here it is, hiding behind the bush. Which emoji is different from the others? It's the unwinking one, with both of its eyes open. These smiley faces look so cool, all but one. This emoji isn't exactly all that smiley. There's something wrong with this keyboard. Can you figure out what exactly? There are 2 8s on it, but no 9s. Which pooch is the odd one? This doggy seems to be friendlier than the rest. Find the odd avocado. Right, it's the one with the heart-shaped pit. Which emoji is different from the others? This little guy is just a wannabe. It isn't a unicorn. It's a horse that's probably dreaming of becoming a unicorn. Can you find the odd emoji? The one at the bottom seems to be even more in love than the rest. The hearts in its eyes are bigger than what other emojis have. One of these music notes is different. Which one? Ah, now I see it. What's wrong with this picture? The calendar claims it's August 2018, but the computer is sure it's still August 2017. Can you spot a teddy bear without a hat? Here it is! There's something strange about this picture, but what exactly? One of the birds doesn't have a reflection. Creepy. Which sheep couple is different from the others? This one, the lady sheep is facing away from her admirer. Amy was walking through a forest and saw three portals in front of her. Each could take her to a different place. The first one would send her to the moon. The second portal would move her to the bottom of the Mariana Trench. And the last one would take her 30,000 years back, when large dinosaurs were still roaming our planet.
Uh-oh.
Which portal should she choose to survive? The third one. Dinosaurs went extinct 65 million years ago. Amy will be safe there. John was looking for a gift for his mom at a shopping mall when he noticed that one of the stores had a mysterious extension. It led to a vault filled with diamonds and gold jewelry. As soon as the guy walked in, the store owner locked him in the room. He told John he had to eat one of the three cookies on the table and managed to get out of the room. Then he'll be rewarded generously. The first cookie would turn John into an animal. The second cookie would turn him into a giant. And the last one would make him invisible. Which cookie should John eat? The first one. He can turn into some small animal, like a hamster, and squeeze through the bars. That's how he'd get out and win the gold. Mr. Lawrence called the police. He said someone had taken his car for a joyride, crashed it into a streetlight, and ran away. The man was sure it had been one of his neighbors. The police questioned three of them. Ivy answered she'd been at work and arrived home only in the evening. Cameron told the police he'd been helping his dad remove old stuff from the attic. And Aaron claimed he'd been hanging out with his friends, eating pizza, and watching the latest series. After listening to all the suspects, the police officers arrested one of them. Who was it? It was Cameron. There's no attic in his house. He invented the whole story. Naomi invited her friends to a pajama party at her house. The only thing she asked the girls was, "Don't enter my brother's room. He loves playing tricks on people. And once you get there, you might not be able to get out." They were gossiping and watching viral TikTok videos when one of Naomi's friends asked, "Wait, where's Rebecca?" Meanwhile, Rebecca went to the kitchen to drink some water, but she got lost and ended up in Naomi's brother's room. The door closed behind her back, and it wouldn't open. The girl noticed a password lock with letters on it. Rebecca looked around and spotted a piece of paper on the table with five numbers on it. 3, 7, 6, 9, 2. The girl thought for a while, then entered a combination of letters and got out of the room. What was the password? The code was the first letters of the five numbers, T-S-S-N-T. An expensive ring went missing from a jewelry store on the first floor of a large shopping mall. The manager called the police. After watching the CCTV camera footage, they had three suspects, a student, a woman with a daughter, and an elderly man. The student said he had agreed to meet with his friend next to the jewelry store. "I didn't even set foot inside," the woman said. "I was at the movies with my daughter here in the mall when everything happened." The elderly man said, "Yes, I did enter the store. I felt unwell and asked for a glass of water, but I didn't take the ring." Who's lying? Look, all the movies running at that time had a 16 plus age rating. The woman wouldn't have been able to watch any of them with her young daughter. So she must have lied.
So, have you ever wanted to start a blog? Well, that's a sign. And this test will help you decide which type of blog will suit you best. Are you ready? Grab a piece of paper and a pen and record your answers. I'll let you know the results at the end of the video. Now let's start with your personality. Which three words would you say describe you best? A. Creative, resilient, perfectionist. B. Attractive, confident, creative. C. Active, adventurous, social. D. Kind, funny, sensitive. Or E. Smart, focused, determined. Do you have any hobbies? Pick it if it's on the list. If not, pick something that's closer to you and that you'd like to try. A. Cooking. B. Music, photography. C. Hiking. D. Reading. Or E. Computer programming. Now, choose a color that best reflects your personality. A. White, the color of peace and cleanliness. B. Royal purple is my choice. It's the color of wealth and nobility. C. Green is the closest to me. It's the color of life and nature. D. My color is happy and joyful yellow. All the best things are yellow. Sunshine, autumn, dandelions, and bananas. Or is it E. Blue? This color symbolizes inspiration, freedom, and harmony. Maybe you can relate to that. What's your favorite way to spend a Friday night? A. I like to stay at home, cook dinner, and maybe bake something as a treat. B. I go out with my friends, and we have fun. C. Go for a walk and wander around the city, preferably somewhere new. D. I like to stay in bed with a book or a movie and some snacks. E. I meditate, do some self-care, and think of my plans and goals. Now tell me, what's your favorite social media? A. Reddit. B. Instagram. C. YouTube. D. TikTok. Or E. Twitter. Think of your budget and the way you spend money. Aside from food and bills, what do you spend the most money on? A. Kitchen utensils. B. Going out. C. Traveling. D. Books. Or E. Online courses. Now, pick your favorite food. Again, if it's not in the photos, just pick something that's more your style. A. Something fancy looking like seafood. B. Salads and healthy food. C. Something creative from a different culture. D. Pizza. Yum. Or E. coffee and croissant. Now, just pick an outfit that represents your personality. Make your choice, and don't forget to write it down. A. Something comfortable and homey. B. Something fancy, expensive looking. C. Outdoorsy. D. Something neat and simple. Or E. Office style. Your birthday is approaching. There's a choice of 5 gifts you can receive. What will you pick? A. A set of new shiny pots. B. A gift certificate to a mall. C. A good and big backpack. D. A new set of books from your book list. Or E. Coffee machine. Out of these famous fictional characters, who do you think is more like you? A. Monica Geller from Friends. B. Jay Gatsby from The Great Gatsby. C. Bilbo Baggins from The Hobbit. D. Hermione Granger from the Harry Potter franchise. Or is it E. Lisa Simpson from The Simpsons? What's your favorite vacation destination? A. A city life. Staying in an Airbnb, going to local restaurants, and getting to know the city. B. A cruise, where I can fully relax and take good vacation photos. C. Remote places where tourists don't usually go. D. A beach. There's nothing better than spending time at the sea or by the pool and watching a movie in the hotel at night. Or E. The mountains, where I can be by myself with my thoughts and come up with new ideas. When you travel to a different city or country, what are you most excited about? A. Food. I love trying different cuisines. B. I love to dive into city life, visit restaurants and clubs, and of course, take many photos and post them. C. I enjoy the scenery and talking to the locals. I love to immerse myself in new environments. D. I love to wander around the city without maps and discover vintage stores and bookshops. Or E. I look forward to visiting museums and exhibitions. You're a traveler walking through the woods. You can go anywhere you want, and there are 5 roads waiting for you. Which one do you choose? A. I'll go towards the river. There's water and some fish I can catch. B. Towards the road. I don't want to get lost. The road means there's a city somewhere out there. C. I'll go towards the mountains. There must be beautiful scenery, and maybe there's a hiking trail. D. I'll go further into the woods and enjoy the experience. E. I'll just turn around and go back where I came from. I don't have time for this. You're on a vacation exploring old caves, and you find a magic lamp. You know what to do. Rub it. So, you rub, and a genie appears. But what a bummer! The genie says that you only have 1 wish. Having 3 is a myth. What will you wish for? A. Unlimited supply of food. B. Unlimited amount of money. C. A teleportation machine. D. The ability to travel in and out of fictional worlds. Or E. The ability to freeze time. Now imagine you got access to a time machine. Where would you travel? A. I would stay in my time. I would rather travel across space, not time. B. To the Victorian times, with fancy balls and dinners. C. I would go to ancient Egypt or Greece. D. I would go a century into the future. E. I would sell it or start giving tours. Imagine that you already have a successful blog. What would you be most pleased to hear about it and you from other people? A. I love your aesthetic and everything you post is amazing. B. You live an amazingly interesting life. I wish I could be like you. See, you have amazing content, and you inspire me to try new experiences. D, your content is interesting and fresh. I rely on you for your recommendations. Or E, you inspire me to grow and be better every day. I hope to be successful like you one day. Now, count your answers. Do you have more of A's, B's, C's, or D's? Then it's time for the results. So, what type of blog should you start? If you have more A's than anything else, then you should consider starting a cooking blog. You probably like cooking or baking, and it's a great way to share your knowledge with the world and try something new. The blog will motivate you to be better and learn more about your hobby. If you got more B's than anything else, then you should start a lifestyle blog. You're probably a very attractive and open person living a very interesting life. You're sure to find many friends, admirers, or just people who will love watching you and learning about your life. Did you get more C's? Fun fact, it resembles my report card. Well, I guess you live moving around and traveling is your true passion. A travel blog is definitely a thing for you. You're a well-traveled person and you can tell people about it, sharing your experiences and inspiring people to explore the world. Was D your most common answer? Then you could try starting a blog about books and movies. You could write reviews, post quotes, make recommendations, or just share interesting details about what you have noticed. It's up to your creativity, and you'll find a lot of like-minded people. Finally, if you pick most E's, then you should consider starting a professional blog on the topic you're qualified in or a productivity blog. You're a hardworking and successful person, so you could share your secrets and inspire people. It's always good to have someone to look up to, and you are a great role model.